Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive, and on the test bench today we are taking a look at the effects pedal interface from Analogue Alien. Essentially, this is a device designed to connect your pedals to your guitar and other sources in a variety of interesting ways that we're going to explore in just a moment. In the intro, you heard me using the EPI, or effects pedal interface, to switch between two effects chains. In send and return A, we had the Seymour Duncan Fuzz, and in send return B, we have the Silver Lake Reverb, also from Seymour Duncan. Now, it's conceivable that you could have a number of pedals in each one of these chains and switch between them seamlessly, but for the sake of this demo, we've only got one in each. But you heard that I was able to switch again with a single click between my Fuzz sound and my Silver Lake sound. I was also able to combine them both using the both switch. We're also going to explore some ways that you might connect a recorded signal to your guitar pedals as well as discussing some wet dry applications using the various connections that are on the EPI. But before we go any further, let's talk about those connections. So you can see from this little handy dialogue on the top, we have a multitude of ins and outs. We start with a guitar input, and this is actually a combi jack XLR connector, which also enables you to connect a balanced XLR to the EPI, which will become apparent why in just a moment. We have a direct through from that input as well. So anything connected to that input will come straight out of this through jack, completely unmolested, but it'll also take a split off to go through these various loops. We have an RCA, which is a phono-type connector with an in and an out, and this is for connecting devices such as chaos pads. You can even connect your phone using the right kind of connections on this, which is very interesting. We have a balanced XLR out and a buffered guitar output, as well as an output pad and a ground lift switch. And on the side, we have a send and return for loop A, a send and return for loop B, and switches to enable either loop A, loop B, or both loops simultaneously. Now, as previously mentioned, you saw that we had connected the guitar input going through these loops, and we're going straight out to the input of our Victory Super Kraken set clean. Let's explore a slightly different application for this one. We're gonna grab an Electro-Harmonix Canyon, and we're gonna grab a second amp, and we'll try running a wet dry setup with those two amps. So what I'll be doing for this one is I connect to the guitar input and I'll run from the through to the input of my Super Kraken, which will be completely dry. And then using the send from loop number A, we will connect via the Canyon to our second amp. And we should be able to switch that on and off with this switch right here. Let's rig that up now and we'll hear how it sounds. Okay, so now we've connected up our Super Kraken as the dry amp by going through this guitar input via the guitar through straight to the front of the Super Kraken. And we're also connecting the Canyon to the front end of an Orange TH30 via the send of loop A. Essentially, when loop A is active, we'll be sending sound through the Canyon into the Orange. And when loop A is inactive, this will be muted and we'll just hear the Super Kraken. The Super Kraken is going to be active on both sounds though. and it'll be retaining the dry notes that I'm playing. On its own, it sounds like this. We're going to begin there, and then we'll bring in the canyon for some ambient kind of sounds, and we'll hear how that behaves. So with this kind of configuration, this is obviously a rather extreme example, but the benefit of this is that if you are using ambient effects like reverbs and delays, even perhaps in a more traditional kind of setup where you're using them to give some space to your solo sounds, for example, using a wet-dry configuration retains the attack and punch of your playing while allowing the ambience to sort of sit behind it where it belongs, even though it's fairly prominent in the mix in this particular example. And of course the EPI makes that super easy, which is really rather nice. Now one more configuration we're going to try with this one is using our guitar pedals to process some already recorded audio. So I'm going to fire up a drum loop and we're going to plumb the EPI in through my pedal board and we'll see what kind of behavior we can get up to. Alright guys, so after much rearranging, I've plumbed my own pedal board through the analogue alien. We're actually doing a little bit of a split that I'll get into in a moment, but we're going to process a drum loop through my pedals, which is a really cool technique if you're in the studio and you want to create some interesting sounds. Doesn't just apply to drums, it applies to all manner of stuff, vocals, keys, whatever. Guitar pedals are a great way to create some new and interesting kind of vibes. What we're doing is coming out of our audience Sonos dedicated reamp output, and we're going to the guitar input. You could just as easily use the balanced input, but I wanted to use a jack. And then we're coming out of the balanced output straight into our recording device, which is off camera. And in loop A and loop B, I have two halves of my pedal board. Now, if we turn our attention down here, on my board, you can see that I have a Boss ES8. I've got a load of analog pedals. The three big Strymon at the back, the Strifactor, I've heard it called, which is a wonderful pun. I love that to death. I'm basically splitting my pedal board in half at the ES8's volume loop. So all of the drive pedals, including the Countess preamp from Victory, all of those are essentially in loop A of the analog alien, whereas all of the Strymon pedals, the Mobius Timeline and Big Sky, are in loop B. B on the analog alien. So essentially loop A is all of my drives and also my wah. Loop B is all of my reverbs, delays, and modulations. I'm just gonna have a little bit of a play and I'll show you what's going on, but in case you're wondering, when I go down to the board and start switching things on, loops 6, 7, and 8 are the Mobius Timeline and Big Sky respectively. So 6 is Mobius, 7 is Timeline, 8 is Big Sky. Loop 2 is a Red Witch Fuzz God 2. Loop 3 is my handmade Klon clone. And if I hit this FSU2 over there, that brings the Victory preamp into circuit. So there you go, that's essentially what's going on. That's what you're listening to. I'm gonna have a little bit of a play. I'm just gonna switch some pedals on. We'll see how everything sounds. I'll play with the loops in here. We'll start with both of them on and we'll explore what kind of sounds we can make. Here are the drums dry to begin with. We'll be right back. So as you can hear, there are absolutely endless possibilities for sonic manipulation in a studio context, and to my mind, that's really where the EPI shines. It's perhaps a little bit large to use expressly just as a pedal board switcher, given that you can only go between the two loops, and there isn't an option to switch them both off. It's either or both, and there's no option for neither. I don't think that's a design oversight given its intended purpose. I really feel like the studio thing is really where it's at. And of course, processing stuff with your existing guitar pedals not only gives you the benefit of expanded kind of tonal palettes and, you know, creative possibilities, but also you know how your pedals work, so there's less option anxiety and your workflow can be a little bit faster. Anyway guys, that is the Analogue Alien effects pedal interface. I've had a lot of fun showing you this today, and we've only really just scratched the surface of the sort of things that you can do with this particular little pedal. But for the time being, I shall leave you there. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive. I'll see you next time.